All right, where I left off in the last one was this threaded rod that I originally had was much too short. There's the original piece. So I lengthened it and then I added a spacer so that it'll kick the handle back, giving me more room to get a hammer in there to adjust the blade. And that looks pretty good. And now I need to trim this. So what are we gonna go to? All right, that should work and give me a lot more room to adjust the blade. Okay, so now the next thing I gotta deal with, do something about the front infill and the mouth adjustment. So the bottom is totally flat. The sides are mostly flat, flat enough. And it's all sanded to 180 on these. I still gotta do the fronts and the back and the top. But I can now take the blade out, take all this out, clean it all up. It's been a lot of work so far. So I really biffed it here on the back. I got a number of deep scratches that are kind of hard to get out. But what's more concerning is I got a nice divot right here. And then I got some other stuff down here, and then it's cracked up there. There's a little bit of separation in here. There's some separation right there. This is chipping out all along that top edge. So what I think I'm going to try doing, I can't remake this piece because it's epoxied and riveted in. And that would be a giant mess to try to fix all that. This won't come off, which I really should have cleaned this up before I installed this piece. The only way to get that off would be to drill it out. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to try doing, see if I can make it look good, is I'm going to fill this with some wood putty, smooth it out, and then I'm going to go over the whole area with some fillable primer, try to work out some of these scratches, and then just do a little bit of paint on it. And I think I can make that look interesting. So we'll see what happens.